Are you looking for a better work-life balance? Well, you may want to move to Portugal. The country just made it illegal for your boss to contact you outside of work hours. That's right, you will be able to disconnect from work and not feel guilty about it. Can I get a hallelujah?
Hallelujah. So,
thank you. This is an actual law in Portugal that's in effect right now. The bill says the employer must respect the privacy of the worker, its working hours, and time of rest and repose with family. The rule is part of a new law regulating working from home. This does not apply to companies with fewer than 10 employees. Employers are also responsible for providing workers with the appropriate tools to do their job remotely and should reimburse workers for any higher bills like electricity and internet. Parents also have the right to work from home until their child turns 8 years old.
What?
Without having to arrange it with their employers.
Wow.
Wow. Wowza.
Yeah.
Mm-mm-mm. Some researchers are now saying you can reduce your risk of heart disease depending on the time you go to bed. There's a study from the European Society of Cardiology that found going to sleep between 10 and 11 p.m. lowered risk for cardiovascular disease. Going to bed before that quote-unquote golden hour or after midnight increased your risk. The connection between sleep and cardiac risk was even more noticeable among women, but I guess this only really pertains to people who work a standard schedule because a lot of people, you know, work those third shifts. And one runner at the New York Marathon ruffled some feathers. Get it? Because it's a duck. Meet Wrinkle the Duck. She ran in the marathon all decked out in her custom red shoes. I wonder if she had to wake up at the quack of dawn to get ready for this race.
That was good.
Maybe she had some quackers and milk after the run. Okay, I'm done.
Wait, I think Eric has one.
You're quacking me up.
Yeah. Thank you. By the way, Wrinkle's time was not recorded, but clearly she's the big winner here.
That's super awesome. Actually moving pretty quick for a duck, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. She got a lot of followers on the top.
She's awesome.
I want to show you a very sweet video. It's the moment a mom found out her son had passed the bar exam. It also just happened to be 1 year since his younger sister died. Take a look. So that man, his name is Ray, he told CBS News, quote, "I will continue to honor my family and my sister with my life. I love my family so much, and I do it for them."
Okay, so I saw this story online as well, and I started tearing up.
Yeah. Well, get ready for more games. The creators of Squid Game just announced there will be a season 2. And this is kind of unusual because most TV shows in South Korea, they actually only run for one season, majority of them. But due to its unexpected global success, creators say, listen, we have no choice, we're coming back. Netflix has yet to confirm the news. By the way, Squid Game is said to be the streaming company's biggest series ever, bringing in nearly $900 million so far. Hey, who doesn't love a good sitcom? You know, like The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Friends, The Simpsons. Those are just some of the most popular family sitcoms of our time. But which one is truly America's favorite? CenturyLink conducted a survey to find out by discovering each state's favorite. So you can see the map on your screen. You can kind of pick out a state you want. In California, apparently our favorite sitcom, The Simpsons. CenturyLink used Google Trends to compile the data for all 50 states. The most popular across the U.S., you guessed it, The Simpsons. Where's Illinois? Oh, The Simpsons.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot of purple there.
Yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We got Schitt's Creek over there. Mm-mm. Everybody's going old school, though. That 70s show, that was a good one, too. Crazy news for NSYNC member Lance Bass. He just found out he is related to another huge star, all thanks to a YouTube series. So the series is produced by genealogy site Ancestry. The show is run like a contest, and the final question asked whether Lance was related to Faith Hill, Britney Spears, or Elvis. So what's the answer? Here you go.
And the answer is B.
Are you kidding me? I don't care about losing because this is amazing.
I know, I guess you really are the true winner here.
Okay, So it turns out Britney Spears is Lance's sixth cousin once removed. What does that even mean?
I have no idea.
I was waiting for you to explain.
That's the one thing I didn't research. I will Google it for you after this. But the two were actually born an hour from each other in Mississippi. Lance says he's always felt a connection to the star and now says it all makes sense.
Sixth cousins. Okay.
Well, they're both good dancers and both good singers, so they've got that in their blood.
And they're both famous.
Yeah. I guess we're all related to,
somehow,
what is that,
right?
That 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon?
Yeah, we're all humans.
Hey, get your tissues ready because you're going to be drooling and you're going to be laughing at this announcement. People magazine has officially named actor Paul Rudd the sexiest man alive. I say laugh because he's a funny guy. The honor was revealed in a comedy sketch with Rudd on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert.
Let's get started, Paul. Are you ready to be sworn in?
Absolutely.
Raise your right hand and put your left hand on a photo of your own face. Did you bring a headshot?
So I could just use my own face?
Yes.
Okay.
I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
To give the sexiest answers I can.
To give the sexiest answers I can.
To be a man.
To be a man.
And stay alive.
And stay alive.
So help me, McConaughey.
So help me, McConaughey.
Okay, that's great. You're ready. When was the first time that you knew that you were sexy?
I guess when I was... When I was a baby.
He's great.
That's what makes him sexy, right? Mm-hmm. Rudd told People he's aware there are many people who should get the honor before him. Now, among his nearly three-decade-long career, Rudd has starred in Role Models, which he helped write. He also held a feature role as Mike Hannigan on Friends, and who could forget his breakout role on Josh in Clueless. The Sexiest Man Alive issue comes out this Friday. Now, because of HR rules, I don't think I'm allowed to say who the sexiest newscaster is here at the station. But on that note, here's Evan.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, I was like, am I going to get it? I mean, you couldn't see, but Jenny and I made some pretty distinct eye contact where I think she made her choice there.
You threatened me if I didn't say your name.
Exactly. It was a nonverbal threat, but you got it.
You know, we're starting off with more details out of Houston right now after the deadly Astroworld Music Festival. That's including new cell phone video. 18-year-old Aiden Cruz, a high schooler in Houston, was at the concert with a group of seven friends who are all trampled on by the crowd. What we did just show you is cell phone video showing Cruz pleading with a camera operator to get help. Cruz says he was trying to help 16-year-old Brianna Rodriguez, who you saw there a second ago, who was one of eight people killed that night. The teen says he was basically accepting he was about to die after being caught in that deadly crush Friday night. The Houston Fire Chief says the 2019 Astroworld Festival had some medical incidents, but what happened this year was unprecedented. He expressed frustration that the show continued even after his department declared a mass casualty event.
Who's responsible for that?
In the plan, it's outlined that that the event directors were the ones that were responsible for essentially pulling the plug.
A Harris County judge is now leading the call for an independent investigation. There's a new trend among the world's elite, apparently. So basically, the story has nothing to do with you and I, but we can live vicariously, right? More and more rich people are now buying super yachts, aka luxury boats, longer than 100 feet. They cost anywhere between $10 million and hundreds of millions of dollars. 200 of these super yachts have already hit the waters this year, and more reportedly are on backlog. Maintaining these massive boats costs about 10% of the purchase price every year. So my advice to you here is do not buy your own super yacht. Just be friends with someone who owns one, right? Or boats in general, I think that's the rule.
Isn't that the rule?
Yeah, that's the rule, yeah.
Hey, move over, Michael B. Jordan, because People Magazine just crowned this year's sexiest man alive, Paul Rudd. The 52-year-old actor is known for his roles in Clueless, Anchorman, Ant-Man. His new title was revealed in a comedy sketch on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert. Rudd says he's totally going to lean into this new title, joking that he's going to make some business cards for y'all. He also joked that he could score an invitation now to sexy dinner night with George Clooney, Brad Pitt, and Michael B. Jordan, all past winners, by the way. But more seriously, the actor says he sees himself as a husband and father first, and also he's fully expecting his friends to give him so much grief over this. Stella, you know, we've been playing the clip from when they announced it on Colbert pretty much throughout the morning. Go check out, I think, probably on our CBS YouTube, my YouTube, we put it up there. It's pretty funny.
Well, and you're saying, listen, funny is sexy.
Because you know what, looks fade.
Yes.
Well, depending on how much money you spend at the plastic surgeon. But funny generally tends to stick around, so.
That you is
know,
true.
I know. And then for a guy like him, he's got both good looking and rich and funny.
And on a serious note, the man does not age.
No, he doesn't. He looks the same when he was in Clueless.
Yeah.
I'm not happy for him about that. Okay.
Jenny, thank you.